Hello, my name is Patty Patria. I'm the Chief Information Officer at Babson College, and today I'm going to talk about generative AI in higher education. I'm going to talk a little bit about Babson's AI journey, which really began in August of 2023, when most places weren't really thinking about AI yet. In August of 2023, we actually had some faculty that came to me and said, we'd love to use generative AI in our classroom, and what tools and technologies can we use? So at the time, we had just switched over to the Microsoft platform for Office 365 and other things, and we started to deploy AI with Azure AI in some classrooms in a pilot setting. Since that point in time, January of 2024, we've rolled out Copilot to all of our faculty, staff, and students, giving our students the capability to use cutting-edge tools inside and outside of the classroom. And then in spring of this year, the college built a all-in AI strategy, where we're looking at AI all through our curriculum, our student experience, and our operations, which I'm going to talk about in a little bit more detail. Why is this important, you might ask? Well, it's important because we want to offer an improved educational experience to our students. Our students are on the cutting edge of innovation and entrepreneurship, and they want to be able to use the tools now that they're going to use in the business world when they graduate. We also want to improve efficiency and effectiveness and give our employees the tools they need to make their work lives better. And last but not least, we want to make sure that we have data-driven insights. It's really important to measure and look at how we're improving our services to our students, our faculty, and our staff. And by leveraging all of this technology, we can do all of those three things. So let me talk a little bit about AI in the classroom and our student experience. As I mentioned a year ago, faculty wanted to leverage AI from a teaching perspective. We leveraged Azure AI Studio and select courses, and we piloted functionality. We then pivoted in January of 2024 to launch Copilot in classrooms with faculty and staff. And now for the fall, we have multiple projects going in various classes with various bots. One of those bots is a math bot that we recently built in partnership with Microsoft and Tearaway. And the math bot is helping students who are struggling in complicated statistics course to answer questions, which I'll show you in a little bit. And it gives our students another alternative mechanism to learning content. So in addition to the information they get from the instructor in the classroom to maybe the support they get in the tutoring center, the bots can also augment that in their educational experience. In addition to that, we have faculty that are co-piloting bots in our Foundations of Management and Entrepreneurship class. We teach students how to prototype new business ideas, and we built a prototype bot where they can ask questions. We have faculty in our sales courses who built sales bots to, again, augment the learning experience so that students can actually ask various questions on the sales cycle or sales process. And based on data that the faculty have loaded from their years of expertise, students can get direct information. In addition to that, Babson really wants to help our entrepreneurial students reach their vision. And so we've also rolled out this fall AI student grants in the amount of $1,000 for compute, Azure Compute in the cloud for AI. So students can build any type of product or service. It could be related to coursework or not. And again, that enhances their overall experience and journey while they're at Babson. Last but not least, we have an amazing group of faculty that have formed a group called The Generator. And this group of faculty is training other faculty and giving them ideas of how to incorporate AI in the classroom. So whether you're an English professor and you want to teach your student how to write better with AI and changing your course assignments based on that, or you're an entrepreneurship professor who might want to teach their students about moonshots, and he's built a moonshot bot to help with ideas for moonshot projects, we're really incorporating it throughout our experience, making the experience better for our students. From an operational perspective, we're leveraging M365 Copilot with our faculty and staff. In July, we recently purchased 200 licenses for faculty and staff, and there was an application process and a rubric for selection of who got to use the tool based on maybe their innovation and how they would use it and what the outcomes would be. Since that point in time, we've already done one survey, and we expect to do two more to see how people are using it in our organization. And you can see from the graphs here that most significant is in writing as well as idea generation, but we are expecting to see great gains in productivity and other things as well. Our goal is to also build AI bots into our support model with our service desk and streamline our AP and procurement processes and legal processes with AI embedded into our ERP. So again, having that holistic, comprehensive strategy. We've also worked to build a governance process because AI is phenomenal and it can do many things, but you want to make sure you address the risk and the security and the testing and the training. And with all of the great new products, particularly with Copilot Studio, which is a low-code, no-code tool, one of the things we worry about is making sure that we deploy those into production safely and securely. So we built an AI working group comprised of faculty and staff, and that will do a couple things. It will help us make sure we have an intake process and a prioritization and approval process for the many AI ventures going on campus, but also that we share best practices of how you build things securely and what the testing process is and how we move things into production in a manner that we're all comfortable with. This group will share insights with our President's Council, the most senior leadership, multiple times per year. And we anticipate having multiple subgroups of this as well, one focused around academics, one focused around risk and security, and the other on leveraging AI and operations. So we've tied it all together from that perspective. This helps us build a full AI all-in strategy for Babson with a student at the focus, but of course, academics, operations, integrating our alumni, our executive ed, our marketing advancement areas, so we can, again, really leverage this to the best of its ability. And again, at the end of the day, our goal with the Babson College One AI strategy is really to help us layer all of the foundations, including governance, enablement, risk management, and education and training, which is also a really important component, so that we can allow our faculty, staff, and students to be able to use these tools to really improve productivity, be more innovative, create better products and services, and really aspire to that entrepreneurial learning mission that Babson has had for so many years. And on that note, I'm going to show you a little bit about our MathBot so that you can see this working in action. So I'm going to segue here to the MathBot. And this is a MathBot that we built in conjunction with Microsoft and Teraway. And it's designed to help students in one of our statistics courses that are having trouble with some of the more advanced math concepts in the course. And as you may know, with COVID, there's been learning loss across the country in STEM courses, primarily on math and science, and we're seeing it too. So we decided to, again, partner with Microsoft and Teraway to help build a tool that would augment student learning. So you see the chatbot here, and you can type any questions into the window. And I'm just gonna type in, what is a scatter plot? Just because maybe I don't understand the concepts of scatter plots and analysis. Right away, it shows me what a scatter plot is, shows me the relationship between sets of data, axes X and Y, and then it also shows me here the sources of where this data is. So if I want to drill in on that particular question a little bit more and say, help me understand the variables X and Y in a scatter plot, I simply type the question in again. And it will refine the information for me and then help me pinpoint in detail what the X and Y variables represent in the various sets of data. When it's done with the answer, it shows again the citations of where it received it from. And for us, this is open source textbooks and we're citing that properly. And I can drill into any of this information and look at the information in graphical form in the textbook to learn more. So in addition to that, there's one more bot that I want to show you, and this is a sales bot that one of our faculty members is working with us to build for his students on sales. And this is built with Copilot Studio. So again, this was much easier, quicker, faster than the more complicated math bot. But you see the sales bot. I'm here to answer any questions you have about sales. So again, here, if I'm a student and I'm learning the sales process, I can say, how do I win out over a competitor on a sales bid? And I'll just type that in. And it will take a couple of moments and look through the vast knowledge that the faculty member has provided. And then it will, in a moment, give us an answer with that information. And once I have that, you can see here, the sales bot has told me, to win against a competitor in a sales bid, you need to focus on understand your client, recognizing that rejection is part of the process, which you might not normally hear in sales, but our faculty members teach that, and treating it as a numbers game. And it's important to analyze and decide and do all those types of things. So then, if I want to learn a little bit more, let's say, how do I understand my customer market segment? I'll type that in. The sales bot will then go back and look and help me drill into that information more. So we see a lot of value with this technology in the classroom. There's a lot of wonderful data, but it's not always easy to harness. But with Copilot Studio, our faculty and our staff can pull this data in, harness it more clearly, and provide our students with tools that help them augment their learning experience.